Welcome to the Cross in the Desert, speaking hope and freedom to Iran. I'm your host, Randy L. Noble, and I'm very grateful that you've taken out some time in your busy life to spend it watching my program. You know, all of us that are parents are blessed by the way our children can be so creative in so many ways. And one of the ways they express themselves to other people, to the world, is through drawings. Now, this is a drawing probably pretty common to young boys and girls. It's a picture of the rainbow. After the big storm, you see the beautiful blue and pink and yellow and green colors of the rainbow arc in the sky. And so that's kind of a typical picture you would see that a child would draw. Or another one, maybe that young boy or girl is trying to draw pictures of mommy and daddy. And so you would see something like this. There's mom and dad and the two kids in this picture on a bright sunshiny day, and that's their little house. And again, kids have a wonderful way of expressing themselves to the world. Just about a week ago, I came across a drawing, unlike the drawings that I just shared with you. This was a very disturbing drawing, something that I wasn't prepared for emotionally when I saw it. And I want to show this to you right now. And this is young Mohana Ahmadi. And below her is her father, Hamed Ahmadi. Notice to the right of the picture, or to your left, it's a picture of a hanging. And below the hanging at the gallows, or the boom crane, is a picture she drew of herself with her mother. When you take a look at this drawing, it is unlike the previous two that you saw. What is so disturbing about this? Young 4-year-old Mohana Ahmadi is trying to grasp the reality of evil in the world all around her. You see, her father Hamed has been in prison in Iran since 2009, and he is one of the 4 Sunni Kurds in danger of imminent execution that I'm going to talk about in a couple of minutes. But I want you to think about those 2 previous drawings, those drawings of things that are delightful, that are something fun for children to draw when they see rainbows, or they want to draw mommy and daddy. And in this drawing, young 4-year-old Mohana is saying something to you and me. She's saying something maybe to the government of Iran. Please, don't hang my daddy. She's a precious girl, and look at this drawing again. She is trying her best to make sense of the evil all around her. This is not a drawing that a normal 4-year-old child would draw ordinarily. But Mohana lives in Iran. And in Iran, there is no religious freedom. A government of discrimination, oppression, and fear reigns in Iran. Men and women alike are not allowed to voice their dissatisfaction about the government or talk about the mistrust of the government. They have no freedom of speech. They have no religious freedom. You see, what is the crime of Mohana's daddy? Why is he going to be hanged? Well, basically because he decided to become a Sunni Muslim. And we're going to talk about that in just a minute. What I want to center in on tonight is this beautiful little young child's plea to you and me to do something for her father and the other 3 Kurds that face imminent execution. And the way that she is reaching out to you and me and pleading with us is doing what normal children do best, and that is to make drawings. And what she is saying is, please, don't hang my daddy. As a human rights activist, when I saw this, I connected with this very emotionally. This drawing came to me via my very dear friend, Shadi Pave, a human rights activist in Canada. She too is Iranian. And when she posted this on Facebook, I knew I had to say something along with her about this. I want you to take a look as best as you can at these 4 Sunni Kurds in danger of imminent execution. Their names: Kamal Mulari, Jamsed Deghani, Hamed Ahmadi, and Jangahar Deghani. What is their crime? Well, originally, they were arrested for the so-called murder of a pro-government Sunni cleric. But later on, they were acquitted of this murder simply because the murder of this Sunni cleric didn't take place until after their arrest. But this is the way Iran deals with discrimination. These are Sunni Muslims, and they hate Sunnis. And to the best of their ability, they tolerate them, but they seek their death when they're able to do so. They are charged with being enemies of God, acting against national security, and supporting Kurdish parties in Iran. At their trials in 2009, they weren't given an opportunity to defend themselves, and the judge in their sentencing them to death said, "You are Sunni dogs who must be hanged." Their families were threatened into submitting to silence, or else something would happen to them. Like I mentioned, they've been in prison since 2009, and made to confess, as most prisoners, political prisoners, are made to confess under torture. Hamed, this young girl's father, is suffering now in prison from internal bleeding with no medical care and is throwing up blood. What is the problem with being a Sunni Muslim? Well, let me give you just a brief, simple history of the political problems between Sunnis and Shias. In Iran, the official Islamic sect is the Shiites, or the Shias. But the majority sect all over the world is the Sunni Muslims. Now, at the death of Muhammad, there was a problem. Who would be the political successor? The Shia party said, look, the rightful political successor to Muhammad, would be his cousin, his son-in-law, Ali. Obviously, he was anointed by Muhammad to be the successor. Well, the Sunnis said, no way, Abu Bakr, Muhammad's best friend, should be the rightful successor. Well, there was this split between the Sunnis and the Shia parties. Now, what really caused the real deep-down conflict was that Ali had a son named Hussein. Hussein was later killed in the Battle of Karbala in 680 by the Sunnis. So Hussein was the son of Ali, who was supposed to be the rightful successor, and he was killed by Sunnis at the Battle of Karbala. And this deepened the wound and the intensity of the conflict between Shias and Sunnis. Now, Shias look to the Imams. They have a teaching in Iran, the 12 Imams, that will give the people guidance. Well, of course, the Sunnis don't look to those kinds of leaders. And the problem is, the Sunnis say, well, the Shias have, you know, idolatrized these men and these Imams. And so that's another reason why they don't get along. Now, there is a teaching in the Shia about the 12th Imam, the Mahdi, who's supposed to come at the end of time. And this, of course, is, again, a source of contention. But since the revolution in 1979, Sunnis have faced discrimination by the Iranian Shias. And they are discriminated against in employment. They're not allowed to broadcast or express their own opinions. And so this is the reason why, deep down, we see this going on in Iran. I want to also show you some pictures about the conflict between Sunnis and Shias. We've been talking about that briefly, Sunni versus Shia. And here are some pictures about the ongoing conflict that you will see. Here are some posters about don't execute Sunnis in Iran. And these are demonstrations. Again, Rouhani and Assad, partners in crime. And so the conflict and the disagreement deepens between Sunnis and Shias. What I'm asking you to do is to speak out and pray for these four Sunni Kurds. On my Facebook page, you are going to see a petition that you can sign and do something about their deplorable situation. Once again, political prisoners in Iran are silently executed. Most of them are deprived of medical care. They're allowed to die because of the many diseases and the brutality which they're treated with. When they're tortured, many of them die from internal organ damage with no medical care. These four are in imminent danger of execution. Kamal Mulari, Jamsed Deghani, Hamed Ahmadi, and Jangahar Deghani. And what I would like to say to you in closing is that God has a few things to say about the evil way people are treated in Iran. And as I was looking through the Bible tonight, I came across a scripture that pretty much sums up the way the Iranian regime treats their people, and especially political prisoners. And I want you to hear this from Isaiah chapter 59. Verse 4, Isaiah writes, "No one cares about being fair and honest. The people's lawsuits are based on lies. They conceive evil deeds and give birth to sin. They hatch deadly snakes and weave spiders' webs. Whoever falls into their webs will die, and there's danger even in getting near them. Their webs can't be made into clothing, and nothing they do is productive. All their activity is filled with sin, and violence is their trademark. Their feet run to do evil, and they rushed to commit murder. They think only about sinning. Misery and destruction always follows them. They don't know where to find peace or what it means to be just and good. They have mapped out crooked roads, and no one follows them, knows a moment's peace." That pretty much sums up the way the government treats people, the characteristics of the Iranian regime. Do you know God is concerned about the oppressed and the hurting? And down in verse 15, here's what Isaiah writes. "The Lord looked and was displeased to find there was no justice. He was amazed to see that no one intervened to help the oppressed. So he himself stepped in to save them with his strong arm, and his justice sustained him." So he himself stepped in to save them. This is what God did over 2,000 years ago in Jesus Christ. God came, manifested in human flesh, to rescue us from sin, to rescue us from our evil hearts, to save us from destruction. So God does do something about the oppression against us, and he does intervene against godless societies that oppress people. But my point is also that God himself entered into the world in human flesh to die on a cross to save us from sin and destruction. So he took the first step in speaking out against evil to save us from our evil self. Because God loves us that much and cares about our eternity and cares about us individually. What I want you to do tonight, in response to everything I've said to you, I want you to remember this very beautiful drawing, this sad drawing by Mohana Ahmadi, this four-year-old trying to deal with the evil in her life. Let's answer her plea in prayer. Please don't let my daddy hang. Please reach out in speaking out and praying for these four Sunni Kurds in danger of imminent execution in Iran. One major way you can do it is not only to pray, but to come to my Facebook page and sign the petition and be a voice for their hope and freedom, and really be an answer to the prayer of this precious four-year-old. Thank you so much for spending time with me on the cross in the desert. Have yourself an incredible week, and I will see you again very soon.